So let's begin this chakra practice in a seated position. You can have your legs crossed. You can be sitting on a bolster or sitting straight down on the floor, whichever feels most comfortable to you. And we want to have a tall spine. So whatever supports you in just sitting up tall and feeling grounded at the same time. You might shift your weight from side to side and move the flesh so you can feel your sitting bones pressing down like roots, literally growing down into the earth. When you have arrived at your tall seat, close your eyes and engage Mula Bandha, the root lock. Softly draw the belly in and up, Uddiyana Bandha. And make the back of your neck long. Draw the chin in slightly, Jalandhara Bandha. Applying these three locks brings us into Mahabandha, or the great lock that allows us to sit tall and allows energy to flow more freely. From this tall seat, take deep breaths. On the inhale, reach through the crown of your head. And on the exhale, press down with your hips into the earth. Feel a heaviness here, a groundedness, a gravity. Press your palms down on your knees as a way to make your body even more firmly planted to the earth. We'll begin this exploration by looking at the root chakra, the base of the spine. This is called Muladhara chakra. It's a four-petaled lotus with a triangle inside of it pointing down into the earth. This chakra is about the energy of safety, of security, of feeling like we belong where we are, a sense of being home. So as we begin movement, let's move with a heaviness and a slowness that keeps us grounded. So start to shift your rib cage over to one side and then pull your belly forward, shift the ribs to the other side and then back, and just make small, slow circles with your torso. As you're doing that, just feel one sitting bone pressing down and then the other. The root chakra allows us to feel supported, to be held by the earth. It gives us a foundation. Go the other direction. Issues that can show up here are issues of our work life, our home life, our family, structure or lack thereof, finances, and trust. Come back to the center, bring the soles of your feet together, butterfly pose, and bring your hands to your ankles, let your elbows press down on the insides of the knees, and just again, feeling a heaviness here. You might use the mantra, I am grounded. And thinking of the way when a teenager gets in trouble, we ground them, we restrict them, we bring them back home where they're safe. create boundaries. I am grounded, I am safe. And then let's release that pressure. Come around to a tabletop position and continue to feel the root sensation of rooting down. So pressing down through the hands, pressing down through the knees. Let's move our spine slowly through cat-cow. Continuing to move with a slow heaviness. We want to plant our roots. Allow your hips to come back to child's pose, knees wide. And feel again just this weight, this gravity holding you here. Allow yourself to exhale. You might feel something pressing your forehead, either the ground or your hands. And just getting a sense here of being stable, secure, and safe. And let's start to bring the attention upward into the sacral chakra, the second chakra. Shift your hips from side to side. Come up onto your elbows and just continue that movement, exploring around your hips. The sacral chakra, Svadhisthana, which means one's own place. Bring yourself up to a tabletop position. And instead of moving front to back, let's start to move side to side, like a sideways bending cat-cow. So this chakra, this energy center, sits between the pubic bone and the navel. It's our low belly. It feeds and serves our hips, our genitals, our reproductive organs, and our lower back. The purpose of this center, this part of our body, is to allow us movement. We're going to make some barrel rolls here. So pull your spine up, slide your hips sideways and down. We did this seated. Now, as we do this moving on all fours, it's going to give us a sense of just kind of juicing around the hips. You've probably heard that we store emotions in our hips. Let's reverse directions. Being balanced in this chakra allows us to feel like we can flow with life. The property of this chakra is water. So let's shift our bodies forward, come into a kneeling plank. And as we exhale back, hips go off to the right and back to the heels. And then shifting forward again, hips go off to the other side and back to the heels. We're drawing the shape of a heart with our hips. If you think about the property of water, water is both strong and soft. Water is yielding, but water can also break through rock, stone. So as we come up into downward facing dog, see if you can create that sensation of moving like water. Pedal your heels, bend your knees. Find soft yet strong flowing movement in your hips. This chakra allows us to move through change with grace, with ease, just like water flowing around a big stone. Slowly walk your feet to meet your hands. And with the feet wide, bend and straighten the knees. And just notice your joints softening like water. With knees bent, bring the hands to the thighs and start to move through a chair pose that's more of a cat-cow. So arching and rounding and just finding that tailbone to the greatest range of motion possible. Come all the way to standing. Take your feet even wider. Toes turn slightly out and let's do hip circles. The knees are soft. Slow, graceful movement around the hips. Just allowing this sacral chakra to wake up. Let's reverse that, moving in the opposite direction. And the color here is orange. So you might just picture an orange light like citrus, papayas, fresh juice. The energy, the passion of the color orange and citrus fruits. Take your feet even wider. Bring your hands to your knees and just start to lunge from side to side. Start to feel space and opening in the inner thighs. And let's just add an arm movement, sweeping one arm up and around as we lunge. Just finding an ease and a gracefulness. Sacral chakra energy. Movement. Getting unstuck and stepping into change. And let's pause with our feet wide, reaching arms high and sunflowers. Just imagine moving through water and water moving through you, unlocking, softening. And we'll reach high one more time. Interlace the fingers, steeple the hands, turn your toes forward, and just stretch your body sideways. Side to side. Coming out into those outer edges. The hips waking up. And the next time you come over one side, let that arm drop. One arm up, one arm down, and just reach so that you feel this clear down around your outer hip. Return to center and switch. Beautiful. Come back to center. Bring your feet closer together. Mountain pose. Turn your palms forward and then just with eyes closed, let's just feel those first two energy centers. Rooted to the earth, safe and stable, connected. And we have a sense of flow, a sense of ease of movement. And so now we travel up to the solar plexus, the third chakra. This sits just above the navel, and it's like a bright yellow sun burning inside. It's from here that we say with conviction, I am. We say yes when we mean yes, and we say no when we mean no. Our personal power is here, like a bright sun burning inside us. So we're going to bring that energy up like fire. Inhale the arms high, and on the exhale, sweep back into chair with a sound like this. Sniffing in through the nose as much as you can, and then a forceful exhale as we throw the arms back. We're stoking the fire. Or ha. Bring the arms high, step a little bit wider. Let your arms come out into a T and then just begin twisting side to side. Let your arms wrap and tap you. So stirring up that energy in your belly. Manipura, lustrous gem. Notice when you are nervous or afraid, the first place you feel that is in your gut. You have a gut feeling, an instinct that comes from your belly, your fire. It's called our second brain. And just pause, soften the twisting, bring the arms up high. Turn to the top of your mat and exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, downward facing dog. And we're going to shift into plank pose. So do what feels right for your body, but let's keep some fire in the belly. We're going to tap one knee down and then the other. All of our core work is work that supports the third chakra. Our energy, our will, our determination. If you'd like, you can drop both knees and pick them up. From this center that we speak about our rights, I have the right to fill in the blank. Exhale into downward facing dog. Reach one leg toward the ceiling, and we're gonna just shift forward into a one-legged plank and back to that down dog, stoking the fire. Come forward. You can stay on one foot or drop the other foot and lower down chaturanga. And then let's move into cobra or up dog, opening up the front of the fireplace. Exhale, down dog. You might notice that you need some ujjayi breath to keep the fire alive. Left leg lifts. Shift forward into a one-legged plank and back into dog. This is where tapas lives in our body. Discipline. Commitment. Come forward and either keep that foot up or lower it as you come down chaturanga, and we'll come up to cobra or up dog. Drop your knees, come back to child's pose. Breathe into your middle back, the back of this chakra, the back of this energy center. Yeah. Let's come forward on our knees. And we'll do just 8 yogi push-ups. Building heat. Keeping that core engaged, stoking the fire. Hold the last one down. Hold, hold, hold. Heat, heat, heat. And then release to the earth. Come to Cobra. And Cobra is a pose of strength for the back. See if you can feel the back of this energy center, the chakra that's warm and strong. And pressing back, child's pose. Tuck your toes, lift your hips, downward facing dog. Take a slow walk to the top of your mat. Bring hands to shins, lift halfway. Exhale, forward fold. Sweeping the arms high, extended mountain. Exhale, chair, throw the arms back. We'll do that set one more time. Blow out as much as you can, and then sniff in. Three more. Reach high, as high as you can. Stretch out the space between your ribs and your hips. Let your arms slowly lower to your sides. Going back to the feet, root down, secure, stable. The hips, flowy, ease. And the core, fire, strength. This leads us to the heart, the midpoint of the chakras, 3 above and 3 below. Bring your hands over your heart. And feel that heartbeat. It's said that this is the place where heaven and earth meet. The 3 chakras below, very earthy and physical. And the 3 chakras above, light and spiritual. And right here in our heart is that connection point. The heart is where we connect with each other from, where we receive love. So slowly peel your arms open and inhale, chest lifts. Gather in, receive love, give love. And then just exhale, scoop back in. Round your back, hug your heart. And let's move like that with breath. Inhale to open and exhale to round. This is our place of love and compassion. This is the part of us that is asked to forgive, to release. This is where we store grief and regret. As you open your arms, take 1 foot behind you, just a small step back, and then exhale back with your hands to your heart, and we're going to switch. This is a Kriya, a cleansing practice for the heart, which is called Flight of the Bird. On the inhale, we open. On the exhale, we close. You can take your feet as far back as you like. You can move back into a warrior 2 or a lunge. Arms can sweep low or high. And you can choose the pacing as well. But find an extreme inhale and a big exhale. this energy center was growing and maturing inside of us when we were between 5 and 8 years old. When we were going to school, leaving home for the first time, learning new social rules. Learning to wait our turn, play fair, listen, raise our hands. All of the rules that allow us to engage with each other in society. Bring your feet together and one more time, open your arms wide. Give and receive. Out through your arms, out through your fingers. Let's take eagle arms. You can choose either arm crossing under. We'll do both. And on the inhale, lift your fingers as high as you can. On the exhale, pull your armpits down and sink as far forward as you can, fingers pointing to the earth. And let's do that a few times. Inhale to lift into a back bend. Exhale, squeeze. Squeezing our lymph nodes in our armpits, stimulating the flow of lymphatic fluid, boosting our immune system. Hold the posture down, squeeze as tight as you can. Drop your chin to your chest and open up between your shoulder blades. And then as you come up, uncross the arm that's underneath, but keep the arm in front of you. And so just have one arm bent and one arm extended. Turn that extended palm up and reach back through with the thumb. And the arm that's in front of you lifts up for the sky. So you're kind of at a diagonal here, shoulders doing two different things. And then you're just gonna wrap the arms around the other way. Find the opposite wrap. And then same thing, inhale to lift, exhale lower. Let's see if you can feel back body and front body working in opposition. Next time we come down, let's hold here and squeeze, 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 chin to chest. Feel the knots behind your shoulder blade softening. The back represents our past. Those knots of tension might represent past hurt, past loss, or regret. Gently release, uncrossing the arms. Keep the bent arm, the top arm in front. The opposite arm reaches out to the side, palm turns up, and then just reach that thumb back. You've got as far as you can, this top arm begins to lift. And then your arms just hold a diagonal. Reach them in two directions as far as you can. And allow yourself to come back to mountain pose. Grounded through the earth. The ability to flow through whatever change life puts in front of us. With a fire in our belly, a strength, a confidence, a power, and an open heart. A heart to give and a heart to receive. We'll move now into the fifth chakra, Vishuddha, the throat chakra, the place where we speak from our truth. Drop your chin to your chest and lift your chin to the sky. Take your feet just a little bit wider. Hinge from the hips. Come down into a forward fold. And let's interlace our hands at the back of our neck, using our thumbs to gently pull down on that ridge of bone at the base of our skull, asking for a little more space and length in our neck. Vishuddha means purification. So we want to try to purify these channels in our throat so that the words that come out come from that open heart. We can't always trust the speech that comes from our brain because it's tainted with so much past and so much projection, but we can always trust the words that come from our heart. So we want to open up this space. Let's bring the hands to the earth. We'll drop our knees to the ground. And let your knees be wide. We're going to come into child's pose and start to just roll up to the top of the head. And then back. It might feel almost like you're going to do a somersault as you tuck your chin to your chest. Just feeling a stretch in the back of the neck. And then an opening in the front as you roll down. Come to the farthest point forward that you can. Chin tucks to chest, and then just breathe into the shoulder blades and the back of your neck. Imagine that purification. Blue light burning to open up space for voice, for clear speech, for truth. Releasing, coming to our knees, let's bring ourselves around to a seat. And we'll take the left ear to the left shoulder. If you'd like, you can place a hand on the side of your head and the other hand on the shoulder, and just pull your fingers away from each other, finding some space in the side of your neck. See if you can direct breath to the place where you feel sensation. Imagine blue light, bright blue light illuminating, purifying the space. And as we release the hand, gently switch sides, right ear to right shoulder, weight of your hand if you like, fingertips assist, pulling in two directions. Breathe into that space. And let's release that and pause here in a seated position with eyes closed. Grounded to the earth, stable and safe. A sense of ease and grace with our movement, our strength, our fire burning inside of us, heart tender, open, voice clear to speak our truth. We bring our attention now to the place between our brows, this third eye. So take two fingers and just give a little pressure right there between your eyebrows. This is our center of knowing, of intuition. We're going to bring our hands together and we're going to rub them together fast and furious to create heat. And when you feel a lot of heat in your hands, go ahead and place them over your eyes. Bathe your eyes in heat. I'd like you to imagine that you're sitting in a white room. Everything in the room is white. And there are many windows looking out. From this white room, you look out, and what do you see? What do you know to be true from where you sit? You're sitting in your seat of intuition. Seeing the world from here. Allow your hands to trace down over your temples. Give a massage there next to your eyes. Dig your fingers into that space and roll. Releasing the fingers, slowly lower yourself down onto your back. And when you get down on your back, draw your knees into your chest. Allow your feet to come to the earth, arms down to the floor, a little bit wider than your mat, and just roll your head from side to side. Massage the back of your skull, the back side of your third eye. And as your head comes to center, bring your palms together again. Let your thumbs touch your third eye. The seed sound of this chakra is Om. Om is the sound, the hum of the universe. The sound, the vibration that connects all of us at a cellular level with each other and with all living things. You might repeat the word in your mind, Om. You could even say it or chant it out loud. Allow your hands to release, come down to your sides, and let your legs extend out for a few moments of rest in Shavasana. Feeling the earth beneath you, holding you like roots, firm and stable and safe right here. Notice energy, blood flow moving through your body with ease, with grace. Like water. Feel that sense of independence and strength within you, your inner self. sun. Notice a heart beating in your chest, the center of love. Worthy of receiving love and willing to give love. Notice the blue bright light in your throat that allows you to speak words of truth from your heart. Your third eye, the place where you see with your eyes closed. There's a knowing here, a truth without words. Let's move from our backs to our sides. Keeping your eyes closed and keeping this energy within, bring yourself to a seat. And we'll finish our practice with a seated meditation. So you can place something under your hips if you like. Once you've found that rooted position, again, press your hands to the earth. I am grounded. Bring your hands to your low belly. I flow with life, with grace and ease. Bring your hands just above your navel, solar plexus. I am strong. My yes means yes, and my no means no. Bring your hands over your heart. I am love. I give love. And I receive love. Just touch your fingers gently to the sides of your neck. I speak truth, and words come easily from an open heart. Your palms together with thumbs at your third eye. I see. I trust my intuition. I know what is true for me. Keeping your heels of your hands together, your thumbs and your pinkies touching, open your fingers into the mudra of the lotus. You can reach your hands a little higher if you like, symbolic of the crown, the thousand-petaled lotus above our head. This is our spiritual chakra, our chakra of connection. our physical human self to our higher self. Our self to divinity. And to each other, to all that is. The lotus grows in deep, dark mud, and its stem rises up through the water to emerge into the light. The lotus flower becomes light in the world. Open, opalescent, glorious light. Allow your palms to come back together and come back down to the center point, the heart, the place where heaven and earth come together. Honoring these energy centers in each of us and in one another. Namaste.